So it is very apparent that Tradelands News has been inactive for a long time, but today breaks that rule. Another huge update has been added to the game that we haven't seen in years, a brand new playable faction. Nassau is now a playable faction, but only to players who are level 10. September 18 marks the date that we got our fifth official faction added to the game, the last one being Furnar Expedition in 2016, a 4-year gap between then and now. Let's talk about that. Nassau is a tribute to Birkeland. They have hostile relations with Whitecrest and are not found in Nova Baresca. They are at war with Hallengard, including everyone else. According to developer Joe, giving his expression on the update, he had this to say in quote, "Not much I can say. It's the first time a new playable faction has been introduced in about 4 years. It'll add some spice. There were some war rules changes today as well. 115 people joined the Navy in one day, which looked very hopeful. With a level 10 requirement and restriction of who can join for now, maybe we'll see some fresh interactions between the factions. If you're not sure about the war rules, I'll keep it short for you. Tradelands has lore, very deep lore to be in fact, and that lore can be partially controlled by the community. That's why when you're in TLO, you will see some roleplay events happening, such as Whitecrest launching a night invasion at Nova Baresca. This lore rule is important because it explains the fundamental meaning of how and why the game works, and in some cases, it can even change the gameplay. If you were a player back in 2015 to 2016, you would know exactly what I mean. Ainola ships appearing in front of Whitecrest, their fort being destroyed, Vernity collapsing from the Verdun-Vernor War, and Ainola taking over Fenwick and putting their own fort in it. The list goes on. If you're wanting to know more about Tradelands lore, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, because I and a couple of people are planning on releasing a big project explaining the lore behind Tradelands. As of continuing what's been happening lately, the current leader of Hallengard, Elder CJE Games, also had this to say in the Nassau update. "I think they were probably added to increase roleplay activity, and to get players excited to play the game again. Having the fifth faction will mean roleplay can't be 2v2s and could be made a lot more interesting with another faction like Hallengard who is hostile to everyone. You have the two central peace trading factions, pirates, and two hostile to everyone factions with unique elements to them." One final quote from a Hallengard raid master, BigTex1212, who has been involved with almost all of the current Hallengard conflicts and roleplay events such as the Aokai communication event, had to say this. He might have added this because he thought Hallengard wasn't going to break the blockade, so Nassau would have apparently replaced Hallen. Now this is a far claim, but he presents this theory because again, he has been involved with almost all of the current Hallengard events for the past couple of months. Here is my speculation. What he is claiming is that Nassau was supposedly replacing Hallengard due to the bad air conflict with the unknown faction, but since Hallengard came back and broke their blockade against the enemies by making it a free port, it left Gnar into an odd position to not being able to remove Hallengard due to the faction having command point regeneration, but still have Nassau ready to become playable. So with an anomalous act, Nassau became an official faction to play on. It is unknown what the moderators have planned for Hallengard's fate. Again, this is pure speculation and should not be taken to the faint of heart. If you're wanting to know more about the lore, stay subscribed to the channel. You don't want to miss this. You may have also noticed that some of the ranks in the official navies have changed as well. Not a coincidence, meet the new ranking system. The Kingdom of Whitecrest got a complete revamp on how their ranks work. Not only do you have to be active and show competent skill to your navy, you also need a certain amount of reputation points to rank up from a technical standpoint. Crewman being 10 rep, able crewman being 20, midshipman being 30, and the list goes on. This new ranking reputation system will also be rolled out to all official navies and Tradelands, not just Whitecrest. It will be the only faction that will receive the special rank hierarchy change. Hallengard only got their current rank names changed, and Nova Baresca will not receive anything from this. And finally, to wrap things up for today's news story, Nassau is getting a flag and uniform contest. Create and design for the new Nassau flag and their navy uniforms. If you have any ideas, sketches, designs, anything, please message EpicMon999. The flag's ratio is 7-4, and their uniform from the navy should have a main brown color, and yellow is not necessary. Nassau is also housing a governor election. The new faction needs a new king, of course. Their first navy leader will be chosen by Players Union, a secretive closed circle group that has been in close contact with Gnar and the moderators. Everyone else must follow navy time rules, and any former Admiral Plus of other official factions cannot run for governor to give new people a try at the spot. If you want more information, the official Tradelands Discord server will be linked below. I will also be open to questions, concerns, suggestions, or just regular chatting in my public server, which my DMs will be open for anyone. Just make sure you're formal about it. And remember, we will be having huge projects coming out soon. Stay subscribed to the channel with notifications on to be the first one to see. That will do for today. Thank you for watching. watching this video, and I am the average TradeLens player that goes by Worldcast, and you just watched TradeLens News. I'll see you in the battle. But if you close your eyes,